and he will be our moderator. I'm very biased to somebody that's running right now because he's been a friend for a long time and a very close neighbor of mine. So,
and the neighborhood. So.
Right. We're not trying to sway anybody in a certain way. So, Mr. Ellis is not a member of the Bryant Park Neighborhood Association. And we also have a volunteer from Eric Bowles, Luke, who's also helping out with the questions. Vice President of Parent Pro Neighborhood Association.
Yes.
All right, but I'm going to turn this meeting over to Ben here, and he's going to read the questions. And the candidates for District 4, we did District 2 last month, although almost every face in here is familiar from that last one, is Herman Robinson. We're going to start with introductions from each candidate. Introductions are 3 minutes each, and then we will have questions from BPNA board members and also members of the audience. Those will be 2 minutes each question, and each candidate answers the question as well. There's 1 minute rebuttal each. Questions from Bryant Park, I went over that already. Questions from the public. Time allowing, we're going to end this the best we can at 9 o'clock or before 9 o'clock. So if we are running close to 9 o'clock, we won't take general questions. And there will be closing comments, 3 minutes each from each candidate.
Okay, thanks.
Good evening, everyone. Who's Connie this time? Okay, so we're going to start with Mary Ann. She's going to get the first question. We're going to rotate through each question. After that, each candidate will get 2 minutes to answer the question, and then a 1 minute rebuttal. Your timer is right there.
Second.
I was just discussing that. We're doing introductions first. Before we get started, do we have any other questions that we need to collect and bring up tonight? Any other questions? Okay, so because we're doing introductions.
Thank you for Bryant Park Neighborhood Association, the Beach Club, and all people who came out to listen. My name is Marianne Posey, and I'm running for District 4 City Commissioner. My mission as Commissioner, I want to provide the highest quality of customer service to all people and listen to what you want. I will be your servant. I vow to do my homework and make the right vote. Smart growth, identify and build on existing areas, identify our assets that will offer us the best opportunity for smart growth and develop strategies to support them. Engage all members of the community to future hold meetings, see what the people and business owners want. Take advantage of all outside funding, grants, which I value to do. Create incentives for investment in Lake Worth. One great one is for the electric department that I've said before, where new businesses with 5 employees or more. You need to fix our pool the correct way and get it open. I'm starting a fundraiser named Save Your Change, Save Our Pool. I'm going to be working with the Community Foundation for Palm Beach and Martin County so people may donate to get our pool open as quick as possible. Homeless, address the homeless issues head on. I vow to attend other city meetings to see how they are dealing with this. Homelessness is a symptom. It's not a cause. It's about seeing things in a broader spectrum, taking into account a multitude of factors. One of the key issues is to have mental health service is ready and available to all of these homeless people. There are a series of issues, drinking, drugs, and mental health, and then people who really want a home. Also, our wonderful vets are not being taken care of. It's a tough one to battle with all the circumstances surrounding the issue. There aren't enough shelters. However, there 19 shelters from Lake Worth to Boca Raton. But the homeless people can't go there because if they're addicted to a substance, they won't be allowed in. And that's, so we need to be very proactive with mental health. Let these homeless people know that they have a name and a reason to be on the serve and to get a home. Parking, create more parking downtown by building a two-story garage and seasonal parking. Sober homes, consider putting a moratorium on new sober homes as long as no other city besides them is being sued. Change city ordinances to further regulate the busing sober home industry as the law allows. Crime goes mostly hand in hand with the sober homes. We added 5 new officers in the new budget light last year under Captain Bear's tutorship. He's doing a fabulous job. However, we have eyes and we can also help them. It make the call, y'all. Code, addressing code issues, we need to clean Lake Worth up. There's too much garbage in front of people's houses. Okay, we need to attract some sustainable businesses on Dixie and Federal Highway. Right now, it is not the perfect site in the gateway of our city. We need to hold our landlords accountable to their lease and consider making North Dixie into Gourmet Row. Thank you.
Some of you haven't decided. I have experience on planning and zoning, historic preservation, neighborhood association development, the neighborhood president's council development. I was instrumental in starting that. I have the temperament and judgment to serve as city commissioner. I understand it's a very important job, and the challenges we have in some of our assets that haven't been well maintained need to be addressed sooner rather than later. Our community deserves a pool, and I look forward to having it open. Some of my issues are certainly crime in the neighborhoods. Sober homes are a issue in the state, the county, Delray, and we have our fair share. One of the problems is that we have no sober homes that are licensed in Lake Worth. We should inspect them. Our code department does have that right and should exercise it. Assets in Lake Worth need to be utilized to the maximum. Dixie Highway is underdeveloped. Our casino is unfinished. We know about our pool being closed, and I want to look forward to maximizing our assets. I want to look forward to working with interlocal partnerships, not public-private partnerships, but interlocal partnerships with other agencies where the money is. The county has money that we could have for county use. So I look forward to reaching outside the city boundaries to have help with that. I want to maintain our lifestyle. We all love Lake Worth, and look forward to no drastic changes in development that would ruin our lifestyle. And I, most important, want to listen to all ideas and criticisms and people that may not agree with me, but it doesn't mean that you're my enemy. And we're all hopefully challenging ourselves for the better city in Lake Worth.
I'm the only candidate in District 4 that's been talking about the continuous waste of our taxpayers' dollars, as well as an inspector general report, property values, safety, and security. I take this election very seriously. This is not a game. This is not an election for an opportunity for you to elect your good friend to a city commissioner's position. He's not qualified to be a city commissioner. Let's not confuse neighborhood association participation with political wisdom, leadership, vision, and goal setting. I am the only candidate that is willing to openly talk about the finances of the neighborhood. I'm the only candidate that is political, that has the political wisdom to see there is an ongoing problem, as the Inspector General has reported. My professional experience speaks for itself. I've worked for the mayor of the city. I've worked for our county commissioner, Shelley Gunn, as well. I'm the only candidate in District 4 that is on the record that I will not support outsourcing any contracts to any company that's not American-owned, as we have done before with the casino for $6 million that is still yet to be completed. When the problems pop up and you go to court, you realize why. I'm the only candidate that has used local businesses for my campaign material in my yard sign. Now, I have to ask Herman and Marianne, what kind of message are you sending when you want us to support you, you want us to elect you, you want to represent us, but you won't even use local businesses? That's common sense. How much could you have saved? I'm the only candidate that has the courage to talk about the finances brought up at every opportunity I have. I'm the only candidate that has addressed the gross financial waste that this city has had. My opponents have demonstrated time after time not even willing to speak about this. I have to ask why. Why aren't we talking about the money, the loss of money in this city? Well, possibly one reason is they don't understand the gravity. Or, the second might be, which is worse than the first, they don't think it's a problem. And then, finally, possibly, they don't want to ruffle the feathers. That is a true... Thank you. Here. That's what leadership is about. That you ask the tough questions. You're willing to take the hits from people that are not going to like you, because you're asking those tough questions. My name is Ellie Whitting. I want to be your commissioner for District 4. Thank you.
Thank you very much to all of our candidates. We're going to start the questioning now. The first question is going to be with Marianne. And we're going to dive right in.
How many minutes?
2 minutes per question for each candidate, then a 1 minute rebuttal following. Okay.
Optional
rebuttal. The question is, are you a paid current member of your neighborhood association? And if so, for how long?
Yes, I am, for 10 years now.
Yes, I've been a member of and paying dues for 18 years since I started the association.
I am not a member of the Bryant Park Neighborhood Association. I am a member of the Eden Place Neighborhood Association. But I feel working for the mayor for 3 years and working for our county commissioner, Shelley Bell, has given me more experience than being a member of any neighborhood association.
I think local contact and input is much more important than Shelley Bass. I value her service, but we are a community that should be able to communicate with our commissioners at any time.
Again, working for the mayor of this city, that I received phone calls in that office from many of you in this room, not realizing that this was a private business. As far as working for a county commissioner, the numerous phone calls for the problems that here, right here in Lake Worth, were asked. And yes, I did deal with them. So possibly because you're in Bryant Park or South Palm neighborhood, Do you deal with tropical reefs? Do you deal with Pineapple Park? As a city commissioner, as a county commissioner, and as a mayor, you deal with everyone. I dealt with everyone in the city of Lake Worth. Working here in the city, I dealt with a lot of people.
Thank you. This next question is going to start with Herman. What should the city do to better utilize Bryant Park?
Well, it's up to our citizens to utilize it. It's up to our sheriff's department to make it safe. It's up to our city to maintain its beauty and lighting and its accessibility. It's a pretty nice park right now. We certainly have to make sure that you feel safe in it. But there's strength in numbers, and if you're there, somebody else might not feel as comfortable sleeping on a park bench if you're having a family picnic there. So use the park and it'll be better.
We have a beautiful band shell in that park. I live directly across the street at the north end of the park. I walk through that park morning, noon, night, or day. It doesn't matter. I am not accosted. No one bothers me. It is a beautiful, beautiful park. I'd like to see jazz on Sunday. I'd like to see more music, diversified music, something for everyone, a battle of the bands. We can certainly afford to do it once we stop wasting money.
We did have a jazz band in 2010 on Thursday nights at the band shell. That was done away with. I'm not sure why. That's something that I would love to bring back. There are needles right now in our park. If you touch one with the plastic on it, the fentanyl will go through your body and you'll overdose. That we have to clean up. We can talk to the homeless. I highly encourage everyone to go there. Maybe we can outnumber them. I don't know, but it is a children's park. So we do have to really be careful on where you step, and especially in the bathrooms. There's people doing drugs in the bathrooms. But I really want to bring back the jazz on Thursday nights. I'm sure people that have lived here that long remember that on Thursday nights. And I think it's a great idea to bring that back. Thank you.
Not allowed to be opinionated, but this isn't an opinion. I highly encourage the candidates to speak accurately, because I did a quick fact check and found that somebody has already mentioned something that was out of place. So please, please, speak with honesty and truthfulness. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Darren. Okay, this next question is going to start with Ellie. The question is, should the city resolve or ordain to comply with federal mandates regarding illegal immigration? To cooperate with ICE in executing that mandate in Lake Worth?
Absolutely. I believe that we should not be a sanctuary city. Absolutely not. You break the law, you're in jail. You don't belong here. Is there a sanctuary place for victims? No, I don't think so. So you're here, you're doing something, you're illegal. Please leave. We're a host country. You can't follow our laws? I'm sorry. Innocent people, law-abiding people, should have no effect. But if you're in our jail, yeah, it's time for you to go.
I'm on the fence with this one. There are parents that are having to go back and leave their children here. I do agree that the ones that are illegal do need to go back. It's a tough call though, because you do see these people working the fields that you're gonna have other people that's not gonna want to. But I do agree that when ICE comes in and we have to take the Washington order in order to do that, we can't go against the national law. But again, when you have parents that are being sent back or children that are being sent down, that's kind of our issue with me. Thank you.
I guess I should give you a political answer, but the fact is that we are a sanctuary city. children in school, and taxpayers, citizens, residents. There are consequences if we become a sanctuary city and then get involved with ICE. I'm not in favor of breaking up families. I have neighbors that work for anywhere, and they're decent people. They work, pay taxes, and if they're not committing a crime, I consider them a fellow citizen of Lake Worth.
Okay, thank you. Next question, Marianne. What endorsements have you received?
I've been endorsed by the Town of Lake Park Shores by Robert Sharu, by the Town of South Palm Beach, Bonnie Fisher, and also the Realtor Board. And also the New Wave Tunnel Company. They have 17 offices. Thank you.
I have worked with most of all of you that have endorsed me. I'm very pleased to say that the Senate, State Senator Jeff Clemens has endorsed me, County Commissioner Dave Turner, School Board Member Erica Whitfield, our esteemed City Commissioners, Scott Maxwell and Andy Amoroso. I've worked with West Palm Beach Commissioners Materio, James, and Motley, and most proud of being endorsed by the Firefighters Association and the Palm Beach Police Benevolent Association. Those people feel that they know me and recognize my ability to serve the citizens over the commission. Thank you.
I entered this race in December. Both my opponents have been in this race at that point for months. I had no endorsements, and I'm happy about that. I'll tell you why I'm happy about that. For the obvious reason, I'm beholden to no one. I owe no one anything. That's why I can stand up here and talk about the finances of the city honestly and openly, and you just take a look at the minutes from our city hall meetings, and you'll see what I'm talking about. Do your research, check your facts, take a look at what's going on here in the city and how we're losing money. But I'm not worried about ruffling anybody's feathers, because I'm my own person. I'm here to represent you.
Are there any rebuttals?
Okay. Sorry? Every question. Every question can be rebutted.
Yes. We entered the race, Herman and I did. I believe at the same time we started when we could actually ask for endorsements. So Ellie, I'm sorry that you don't have any. However, Herman and I have been working this for a long time. And we do take our endorsements extremely serious for the people that did endorse us. Thank you.
The employment of the mayor and Commissioner Shelley, that I don't know how what the term of their employment was, but it would be interesting to have that.
What is
my time?
Ellie, did you have a rebuttal?
No, I have
nothing
to say.
Well, if you mention it, I consider that you're thinking of it as an endorsement. I did mention, or did not mention, the Human Rights Council has endorsed me too.
Sorry, I think Herman was referring to my employment. Is that what you were talking about, Herman?
Right.
Who I work for?
Ladies and gentlemen, let's just talk to the audience and not to one another. Thank you.
I was trying to clarify what he said, and sometimes I have a problem understanding him. So I wasn't sure. What were you referring? I don't understand.
The questions are for the candidates, not candidate. Two candidates.
I mean, he said
say thank you, everybody. We don't have another round of rebuttal. We have a single rebuttal.
And let's, I understand everyone's very passionate about the race, but let's all be very civilized, please. Thank you. Okay. Who's next? The next question. We have a number of empty storefronts downtown. What would you do to attract new businesses to Lake Worth? And what types of businesses would you like to see come to Lake Worth?
Having had a business downtown, I understand how difficult it is to have a small business family operation. I would want the realtors to sell our city when it's lights out and the community that we have. I would like to see a variety of shops. I would like to see more the Bamboo Room open as it was as a music venue to have Austin East in Lake Worth or Nashville type growth in our town that we have musically.
I was a small business owner. I owned a couple of businesses. One of the businesses I had owned was a franchise business, a furniture refinishing. Someone I know here in the city has a contact for over 400 franchise businesses that are American owned, which is a prerequisite I'd like to see. Franchise businesses are an opportunity for mom and pop stores. We're a perfect location for that. Don't want to see box stores, don't want to see big chain stores. Very proud of that. We need to be actively recruiting. We do. But what are we only showing people that we have? We have terrible schools. We have crime. We have issues that we need to resolve. I'd like to see first a school of the arts, something more than a Dreyfus school, so we can attract people. There was this fellow named Courtney Haynes who said to me, Ellen, I have a business, I have a call center business. I can actually employ 100 people. And he took a look at the shops downtown, and he's still working on it. So hopefully we can.
I would love to see the Chamber of Commerce come back for the businesses. Actually, some people actually still think that we have one, and we don't. It's very important for the city to work with new businesses. I also was a small business in Lake Worth in the late 80s to early 90s. I believe Herman and I are the only one that had a small business in Lake Worth. And it's important to know that you need the city and the people behind you here. The city's doing